Hi there, welcome to Serenity by Sue, Whispered Confessions. I started naming these Whispered Confessions and then I realized I wasn't really confessing anything. So tonight I thought I would share a little bit, something of a confession, and I could share with you what I actually do in my real life. It's not real life, but it's my life, and there's something that I'm very passionate about. Wait, I think I told you guys about this yesterday, but anyway, it's worth repeating. Supporting an organization called Magnolia Rose, they help victims and people at risk of being trafficked. Central Virginia in the Shenandoah Valley, which, if you haven't visited here before, you must. It's so beautiful here in Virginia. I'm not originally from Virginia. I am from Chicago, and it's painful to think of what's happened to the city. I don't know if I would go back because of the crime and just the general feeling that it's really lost its way. Maybe I'm wrong, and if you're from Chicago, please, please tell me different, but my sister was the last of us. I have 6 brothers and sisters, and I have 4 stepsisters, and we all live together. From when I was about 10 until 18, and well, that was fun. It was like living in camp every single day. Chore charts and just general mayhem, and I guess I wouldn't trade it for anything, but it was pretty intense sometimes. Yes, I'm from Chicago, but I also lived in a very little town called Rhinelander, Wisconsin. And if you know where that is, please comment below, because I lived there for, how many years? 10 to 18, so 8 years. And at times it seemed like the longest 8 years of my life. So cold, maybe I would consider moving back. Still have family there, have family in, well, no longer in Chicago, which is so sad. Both my mom and my dad were from Chicago. All my family is in Chicago, friends, but now everyone's left the inner city. Well, they left the state. That's a picture of Hong Kong. I miss it so, so much. I cannot even tell you. But I hope to be going back to Hong Kong at the end of, in November. And that is the plan. So where are you from? Tell me in the comments below, because I would love to know where you're from, where you're listening from, where you call. Question that I've been asking a lot lately is where? Really, for me, Hong Kong is home, which is odd, but I've lived in Hong Kong longer than I've lived in the US, so a lot of things are just different and hard to adjust to in the US now, so I suppose it's normal. Because when you leave a country and you go to a different one, it's such a huge culture shock, and also trying to adapt to the language and the different ways. And it's really weird when it's reverse culture shock. Like, I'm from the US. I was born here. I left when I was 20. No, after school at 22. So I went to Hong Kong when I was 22. And I didn't come back for 30 years. So a really long time. And, you know, learn to speak the language. Cantonese. Anyone speak Cantonese? Le ho ma, which no one says. Le di ma. So I miss speaking the language. I miss friends and just the general way of life in Hong Kong. So I hope to go back and just be more of a nomad. Live in a bunch of different places. Visit friends around the world. A lot of friends have left Hong Kong and have gone to the UK. I've got family in Norway, cousins, and my grandmother was half Norwegian. So Norwegian, Swedish, English, Czechoslovakian from the Czech Republic. If you're from Czechoslovakia, I'm going to butcher this name, but sorry, the Czech Republic. I apologize. The Czech Republic, but my grandmother was born in, okay, it looks like Rocky Canny, but I know that's not how you pronounce it. And I've listened to a video on YouTube how to pronounce this city. It's just south of Prague. I think it's like southwest of Prague. Roknikani. I'm saying it wrong, but anyway. So my grandmother was born there and came to the US when she was 13. Now, my mom, that was my mom's real mom. But my mom was adopted by a, if you're a dentist, my grandfather found AGD. If you're not a dentist, you probably have no idea what that is, but in any case, my grandfather founded that organization, and now it's second only to the ADA. It's a continuing education organization, and so anyway, that's to say that I am Norwegian, Swedish, English, Scottish. You know, we did the ancestry.com and we found we were able to trace back all the way here. And so I found it really interesting why I ended up here in Virginia. And maybe that has something to do with it. I don't know. I don't know. But I just find it so interesting, the whole ancestry. Tracing your lineage and all the generational trauma and generational, just your bloodline, what you bring with you into your life and what you will pass on to your children and your grandchildren. It's just super interesting to me. I could spend hours on ancestry.com, but don't have a lot of time for that. In any case, I don't really have much more to say tonight. I did turn my microphone, so hopefully this will be a little better. I've been monitoring. I can actually see my SSL2 interface, which I love. It's so cool. It's got the knobs on the top, because normally when I do recordings, it's in a studio where they've got massive, massive audio panels that I can't even begin to understand how they use them. I think I would probably use like one or two of the panels, but in any case, I hope that this will be better in terms of, it is a unidirectional microphone, and yeah, I really like it. I took the sock off it because I thought, well, I could put a screen, I could put a big fluffy ball on it, but I think it's kind of cool, just the mic and me, mic and me. In any case, slowly, slowly getting back into the swing of things, rolling along. And don't forget, check out the links down below for Magnolia Rose. I support them because they help women who are at risk or who have been trafficked. And again, I can think of nothing worse in this world than being confined and not able to go where you want, do what you want, be who you want, and just be safe. So please check out that link to Magnolia Rose. And also, here's my pink and my blue rollers. I love them. They really do help get in touch with your body, and I think that's just so important. You can carry them around anywhere and just roll them. They'll actually roll like right on your skin. So they don't hurt. They don't pull like your skin. I suppose it's kind of like those rollers on your face. You know, the ones that are supposed to make you look really super young. Thank you as always for joining me, if you've made it this far. And I'll just keep doing these every day until I get into a place where I can actually set up a better studio. We're actually in temporary housing right now. Well, it's not temporary housing, it's a friend's place that we're staying.